OpenAI had a massive data breach over the weekend. Are you exposed? Is your business exposed? We'll get to that in just a moment. We're also today going to be covering a new McKinsey report that reflects a massive drop-off in job applications and job listings for a couple specific fields. We'll get to that in just a moment also. And then lastly, we are going to cover a major shift in college diplomas. I think you will be very surprised by what we have to uncover. If you're new here, by the way, 6 days a week, we're bringing you the freshest AI and career news, the stuff that you need to know to stay relevant, respected, and financially free. Guys, men are gonna be trounced over the coming decade when it comes to jobs, career, and meaning. And if you wanna remain relevant, respected, and financially free, it starts with understanding what's happening and how to capitalize. Hit subscribe so you stay up to date. So let's start today with, to be the biggest story, which is the massive OpenAI data breach. Please, and guys, OpenAI is the parent company for ChatGPT. So anybody that uses ChatGPT, your ears should be perking up. And if you're a taxpayer too, and we'll get to that in just a moment. So what happened? Well, one of their third-party analytic companies, Mixpanel, reported a breach several days ago in late November, and the impact was to API accounts. And right now there are thousands of developers, software developers, who have integrations with ChatGPT and OpenAI. If you have an API that is connected to OpenAI, you should be checking with them, because what was exposed? Names, emails, locations, operating systems, organization or user IDs, referring websites. So they're going to get a lot of information on the demographics and the psychographics of the people that use your products and services. What was not, according to them, what was not exposed are API keys, passwords, and payment details. So what is and is not happening? Let's cover that real quick here. Okay, so what is happening is they are getting a lot of customer and consumer information from your databases, which is going to lead to some pretty high quality phishing emails. We cover this, I'll put a link to it here. We covered this a few weeks ago in how effective AI is at empowering phishers and scammers. Their emails are way, way more effective, way more customizable using AI. You could have someone in Indonesia who is able to get very robust, very specific information about you, your city, the way that you think, the videos you watch. It's very easy for them to get sophisticated data just by searching for your name and using AI to write these highly catered emails. In fact, if you're a realtor, you're especially in trouble, because these guys are going to be really, really clever at getting you to divulge information about properties or about your personal realty practice. What it doesn't give access to is login information, credit card information, et cetera. However, you should be in communication with anyone in your organization about phishing. This is a good time to remind people about phishing, because ChatGPT, OpenAI had this major dilemma. Now, what I think is interesting here is we're in this move now to make everything AI powered. We're integrating AI into everything. In fact, probably your favorite AI tool is using some sort of OpenAI API integration to function, okay? Or at least another program, but OpenAI is huge, okay? So what does that mean? Well, with breaks in the system like this, that is dramatically going to impact the adoption rates of these tools. It's gonna slow things down. And I think that is an important thing to notate here. I do see you guys in the comments. By the way, your comments are fire. If you have a really good comment, put it below. I will pin it. If it is excellent, I have done it in the past, I will do it in the future. But one of the comments that I see you guys post is that, well, what's the point of even trying to compete? AI is gonna be able to do everything it better than we do. Well, we just don't know that that is the case. Guys, there could be a world where robots are handling all of our jobs, but I don't know if you've watched a recent humanoid robot video. A, most of them are being remote operated. And B, when you see them automated, they're like running into mirrors, they're knocking over items, they're stepping on the dog's tail. They're just not there yet. And listen, I'm not saying that they won't get there, but what I am saying is this. We tend to overestimate what technology will do in the short term. We underestimate what it will do in the long term. So, long story short, don't give up on you just yet, boys. Don't give up on you. Regardless, this will slow things down, especially when it comes to government, financial, and health sectors. These are places where a lot of sensitive personal information is being used and is required. Big time, like really, really important information. And if this information falls into wrong hands due to a hack or a cybersecurity threat, it could cause tons of chaos, as you can imagine. But what's also interesting here is, guys, OpenAI has a $200 million contract with the Department of Defense. They also have a GSA partnership with the federal government, giving 90,000 federal employees access to ChatGPT. So what does this mean? Well, OpenAI is huge, and they are already very much integrated with our government and with a ton of different softwares, thousands of softwares. And when a hack like this happens, that is a little bit scary. You may recall about a week or maybe 2 weeks ago, AWS, Amazon Web Services, was down. The internet basically completely broke. A few days later, Cloudflare went down. A bunch of other softwares broke. So when you start to see these softwares, you can how one software going down can impact the way that the world works, how one cybersecurity threat gets involved, it shuts down the way the world works. I think that is pretty compelling. Again, type in the comments below what you think about this OpenAI. Is OpenAI done? Are they dead? Should we still use OpenAI in our API integrations? Should the federal government be going really hard into software agreements with companies that have had leaks, cyber threats? Put in the comments below. I'd like to see it. And by the way, if you do want to keep up with the latest news, in addition to subbing the channel, you can subscribe to my newsletter. There's a weekly email with all the biggest stories going out on Saturdays. Sign up for that on AIupdate.ai, AIupdate.ai. Guys, we want to create a world where men like you and me are able to provide for our families. We're able to have financial freedom. We're able to remain relevant and respected. Go ahead and sign up for that completely free newsletter, AIupdate.ai. You should do it right now. Okay, second story of the day that I think is big is story from McKinsey. It's a study from McKinsey, which shows a decline in job ads for AI-exposed jobs by 40%. So there are a few jobs that are seeing a huge decrease in the amount of job ads that are out there. So if you went onto a platform like Indeed, for example, you're not going to see these listings. They're down 40% in these job advertisements in these AI vulnerable roles. And I want to take a specific look at London, which is interesting. I have some specific numbers here from London looking at some AI exposed roles. So we're looking at telemarketers, bookkeepers, and data entry have seen huge, huge drop-offs. If you are in telemarketing, bookkeeping, or data entry, I don't know what else to say. Those jobs are being taken away. They are being outsourced. They are being replaced by AI. There's a bunch of others. These are the ones that are highlighted in the articles that I'm seeing here from the McKinsey study. But we see other, like customer service, anything in a call center. Anything in a call center is high risk. FAQs, customer service, HR. HR is big on the chopping block. We're seeing that week after week after week. These companies are laying people off. And anyway, we see these AI exposed roles of telemarketers, bookkeepers, and data entry are on the decline. Now, what is on the incline? Where should you be putting your marbles? Guys, construction is blowing up. There have been 100,000 AI resistant positions added in construction. The European Commission expects a shortfall of 4 million workers plus over the next several years. So we're seeing a big decrease in the amount. We just don't have enough skilled construction workers to meet the demand. And why is that? Infrastructure, guys, computing ability, data centers. Data centers are completely changing the map. They are going to, data center construction, I believe, will dictate the way the world looks over the next 10 years. Data center construction, and furthermore, power, nuclear power, solar power, gas power, hydropower, wind, it all matters. Energy is life. Energy is life. And so you're seeing data centers, roads, internet lines, electrical, HVAC, anything that's in high-skilled construction that's going to be involved with these data centers is going to explode over the coming years. Now, that being said, there is something to be aware of. This is a double-edged sword when it comes to data centers. You need thousands and thousands of construction workers to build The problem with data centers is they do not require much demand. It may take 5,000 people to build a data center, and it might only take 100 to do maintenance on the data center. So you gotta weigh what you're doing. That said, I believe personally that if you're involved with building data centers, you understand how the electrical works, you understand how the cooling works, you understand those systems, I believe you're gonna find work over the coming years. I just don't see you kind of like falling off into oblivion. I mean, there is a belief that robots are gonna take over all this work. I just don't, maybe, I don't know. To me, it feels like we're a long way from there. Maybe 5, 10, 20 years, I'll change my tune. But it does feel like we're a bit of a ways from humanoid robots building everything. That said, we're gonna be keeping close eye on it. I covered this a few weeks ago on the channel. China is building manufacturing robots like crazy. They are building 10 times the manufacturing robots there in China than we are in the United States. So there could be a major shift here over the coming months. Regardless, construction, we're seeing a huge increase in the need for construction. So if you're thinking about where can you get in, where can you fit in, and by the way, you might not necessarily, like, let's listen. Let's say you're a 40-year-old guy like me. You've been in a career, you understand something, you don't necessarily need to drop everything and go into construction, but you can find ways that you can overlap your skill set, the skills that you have. Maybe you know about sales, maybe you know about marketing, maybe you understand customer service more deeply. Like, I don't know what you do. Maybe you understand food service, maybe you're a chef. Okay, what if you were the biggest chef to data center construction workers? Do you kind of get where I'm going there? How do we overlap the skills that we already have with the skills that are in demand? That, my friends, the riches are in the niches. If you get really good at that, then you're gonna find a nice lane to succeed in. At least that's the way that I see it. You know, for me, I'm trying to merge what I do in marketing and video production with the various markets. So, for example, how can we repurpose YouTube videos to build answer engine optimization in LLMs? That's something I'm interested in. How can we create more AI-generated video that looks good and sounds good and actually converts in ads? These are things that I'm looking at personally. You got to look at it in your own way, right? What is your context? What are your skill sets? What are the upcoming demands? And how do your ideas overlap? Boom. By the way, that is that story. We're going to finalize it here with a quick, I think, interesting story and a shift in how college students are looking at college. And listen, we covered this just last week. 25% of unemployed people are college graduates. They are, quote unquote, the wealthiest among us, at least with the most upside. They've gone to college, they have $100,000 in debt, and now they cannot find a job. And in fact, the people that do find a job, 40 to 50%, are underemployed. They are taking out jobs that do not require a college degree. So what are college kids saying? They're saying, well, I feel like I've been scammed. I feel like this college thing might be a scam because I took out of this debt. I have this degree. I can't find a job. The job market is changing. What am I gonna do? Okay, so what's happening? Well, US universities are reporting a 25% surge in AI-specific enrollment. So this is pretty obvious here. What's happening? People say, AI is changing my world. I'm concerned about AI. What do I do? I'll go to this degree has AI on it. Maybe I'll do that. In schools like Stanford, added on 10 new AI programs. A buddy of mine over in Utah is working with BYU on an AI program over there. So there's a lot of, I mean, AI education is just changing the world, guys. The thing that I wonder is, like, do you really need to take out debt and go to school to learn AI? Because for my buck, I think it's better to get an internship somewhere, work underneath someone. I just don't, listen, guys, I have a college degree. I enjoyed college. It was a positive thing for me. But I just don't know that it, because the reality is if you're gonna start an AI curriculum, let's say you sign up for an AI course now. In 6 months, it might be completely different. It could be completely different. So just by the end of your four-year career in AI, everything might have changed. Everything you learned might have changed. So it's just crazy. It's like, you know, if you went to school to learn Spanish and then halfway through your degree, they ended up deciding, no one's gonna speak Spanish anymore. We're just gonna speak German. How would that impact your degree? Probably not too well. So anyway, huge shift in what kids are going to school for. AI seems obvious, but I'm still on this fence. Like, should I continue to invest in my kid's college degree? For the meantime, I am, but it is something I think about. I don't know about you. All right, boys, thanks for watching today's video. If you like today's video, you will love the news from yesterday. There's always something that's impacting your world, and I find that the people that are in the know are gonna have a big advantage, whether it comes to investing, their time, their money, their resources, leading their family. Stay with it, boys. All right, I'm gonna get back to work. It was fun chatting. Check out the video. See you there. Peace.